So understand, God does not use, God does not do things, you know, he does not operate by the wisdom that governs things here on the earth. He used what I would say, the laws of the heavens, the wisdom that is divine, the wisdom that is first of all pure, the wisdom that is above in hierarchy to the wisdom of the earth. So if you run your life by the wisdom of the world, you will realize that you will not prevail, because the wisdom of the earth, the wisdom of the world has its limitations, it has its gaps, it has its vacuums. But the wisdom of God is complete. The wisdom of God does not have, you know, it doesn't have vacuums, it doesn't have gaps, it doesn't have spaces. It is complete, because this is the wisdom by which the universe was created. So at the bedrock of creation is the wisdom of God. At the bedrock, at the foundation of creation is the wisdom of God. And this is the wisdom that runs the universe. It is the wisdom that runs the systems that are on the earth right now. It is the wisdom that has preserved everything to run, even as it is running right now. It is the same wisdom that has preserved that avocado trees have always been producing avocados until now, because the wisdom that created them, the wisdom that said, let there be, it is the same wisdom that has sustained them until now. Now, the wisdom that God used to create man in his image and in his likeness, it is the same wisdom that preserves man until now. But we have to plug into it for us to be able to be fruitful, for us to be able to multiply and increase, for us to be able to rule, for us to be able to exercise dominion over the fish of the sea and every other thing, every other aspect of creation. We have to plug ourselves into this wisdom so that we can be nourished from this wisdom and be able to manifest. Hear me, child of God. In John chapter number 15 and verse number 7, Jesus will tell the disciples that if you abide in me and my words abide in you, then you shall ask for anything that you desire and it shall be done for you. That if you abide in me and my words abide in you, then in verse number 8 he says, if you abide in me, then you will become very fruitful. And when you become fruitful, it delights, it pleases the Father. For us to be able to operate with the laws of the heavens and the wisdom of God, we must plug ourselves into God. We must plug ourselves into the wisdom by which he created us. We must plug ourselves into his blueprint. We must be in the socket of why and what and the hows he saw when he created us in his image and likeness.